Hello viewers, welcome to my channel PC Geo Kimberlite, a source of diamonds. Today we are discussing an important topic on from stratigraphy, that is the geological timescale of the earth. I am Dr. Sajid Umbekar, associate professor and head department of geology, AKI, Pune College of Art, Science and Commerce, CAMP, Pune, Maharashtra, India. Affiliated to Savitri Bhai Phule Pune University, SPPU Pune, and formerly it is known as University of Pune. Let's start with this, the geological time scale. Yes, every student who has come in and joined as a geology, he has to know what is the geological time scale and what are the important bases are there, what are the divisions are there, and what will be the age of the earth is there, and how the rocks have been there, and how the things have been evolved with this. So the first one that everyone should know, that whatever the age of the earth which has been dated today, now it is 4.6 billion. If you see the 10-20 years back, it is 4.5 billion. Then 4.54 it is given. Now it has been given as 4.6 billion years, and still the scientists believe that the whatever the age of the earth is there, it should be more than 5 billion. So here the important thing which is there, we have to reveal the two important things where we get. One, we get a fossil, and second one, we get a rock. These are the important tools, and with these tools we have to see how the rocks have been evolved, and with this rock evolved or animals which have evolved. On the basis of that, we want to see that how the geology has been evolved, the life of the earth, how the evolution of the life of the earth has been evolved. So that will give you the earth's very long history. If we compare, our age is roughly 60-65 years, but out of this 20 years I've spent only in getting the knowledge, PhD degree, and try to understand the concept, and then you can start making any one of the topic and start doing your research, and maybe in next 20-30 years you will be work hard and might be make a good contribution and may come out with a good hypothesis, concept you can put forth, and that will be a valuable contribution in the geological times in the future. So anything will be happen in the future. So the two things which will be important for the student, first, whenever they wanted to learn anything, the two things are basic. The first one, interest. If he has an interest in that particular thing, in studying or grasping the knowledge, he can grasp very easily. For example, a small child, if you give the mobile, he can play all the things on the mobile. We could not handle properly the apps properly, but that's small child, 2 years, 3 years, they can play with the mobile because they have the interest in that. Gadgets are the crazy for that student. So they have the interest. Second one, the belief. You should have the belief that I can study and I can overcome whatever my goals are there, tasks are there. A student of a 35% in 10th standard, as well as 35% he has got in 12th standard after getting 2, 3, 4 atoms, he has been taken and take 2, 3 years to complete that 10 to 12 years journey, and after he has come to the BSc, I have seen in my life there are number of students who are there, they have gone 80, 85, 90% mark, and they have done MSc in Pune University and gone for research in US. So this didn't happen. So the belief is a very important one. Second is the interest. If you do two things you have in you, then you can grasp very fast. What we have, the enthusiasm is there, passion is there, determination, dedication, devotion. Yes, all these things will be comes into the play, and you are going to make out your personality in a total different manner. You have to make out that. So you have to see your own self. So here, when you are going to see the geological time scale, we have to reveal what we have, the earth which has separated from solar system, 5 billion years back it is there. So we have to see how these earth has been revolved and it has been evolved completely. Similarly, the life which is there on the surface of the, when it is started and how it has been evolved, we can study that also. Then similarly, we can see the whatever the changes we are going to see on the continent, on the oceans, then that will be going to give you the complete what we have, the history, how the geological history you are going to study with the help of these two important tools. One is rock and second one fossil. So this 4.6 billion years we can divide, but oldest rock which is there on the surface of the earth, which has been dated as 3.8 billion years. So from 3.8 billion years to the what we have the present one, we have to divide this time, and now this divide the time in a proper fashion. So the broadly the first major division which we have done is the eon, and this eon we are on the simple basis what we have in the botany, that the plants which are there, they are divided into two categories. One is called as Phanerozoic, one is Cryptozoic. What is a Cryptozoic? That is a non-flowering plant. Phanerozoic, it is a flowering. The same concept we have been taken into this, and where we have been no life, no fossil is there, we called it is the Cryptozoic eon, and where we are going to get the life, fossils are there, we call them as a Phanerozoic eon. So these two broad divisions. And if you compare the age wise, Cryptozoic is a very broad as compared to the what we have the Phanerozoic. Then these eons are divided into eras, eras divided into periods, periods are divided into epochs, and epochs are divided into the ages. So this is the way the geological time scale has been constructed. For this is a very vast and broad, and you have to be think out of the box when the imagination is everything you have to make into this. So these are just what we have is the geologists which are there, they have to be think out of the box, and how we are going to get these evolved time, we will study with the help of the fossils which we are going to get, and whatever we have the rocks, and these rocks, igneous, sedimentary, metamorphic, they found on the layering is there. So the stratigraphic correlations we have to make, vertical, horizontal, yes. So that with this fashion we want to study that part. And in this we are going to see field observation. Whenever you go into the field, directly you can get the observations which are there. What type of rock is there, what type of fossils which are exposed, what are the radiometric dating is there, carbon dating, strontium, potassium strontium is there, whether we can use uranium, thorium dating is there, or we have the oxygen dating is there. So many datings are there. So with this, how much life we can find out. So we have to have that particular knowledge also. The paleomagnetic orientation, we can study the paleomagnetic orientation. Means for example, if a magma is erupted in the year 2000. Now we are there in 2021. Say the magma is erupted in 2000. And at that particular point, whatever the north-south is there, so those minerals which are crystallized, if they contain the metals, iron is there, so that iron will having that year's north-south, 2000. After that, say 2010, there is another magma is erupted after 10 years. So at that particular point, whatever the north-south of the 2010 is there, that will be the governed by the mineral which having the magnetic one. So orientation is different, so there is a deviation is there. So like this, we want to study the paleomagnetic orientation, and from there also we can get the study. So the Wegener has taken a very important one as evidence for the paleomagnetism for giving the continental drift theory. Then orbital revolution of the earth, how the earth revolved around itself and how this magnetism is changing. So that has to be done. Then how is the rotation of the earth is there, that has to be studied properly, and we want to see the major events which have been taken place in the geological time scale, that is a mass extinction. There are the five major mass extinctions are there, and everyone knows about the K-T bonding, and there is the Permian Triassic, very famous one, Then there is another one will be there in the what we have. Silurian is there, Devonian, they are there. So, and one more is there. Yes, I don't remember. So, there are the actual five are there. Out of these two are the very famous. There are Permian, Triassic. There is the one where the all the plants with Glossopteris, Gangopteris, that will be extinct has been taken place. Mass extinction has taken place. The second one, KT boundary is there where we have the dinosaurs are extinct. So, they have been giving that reason that to make the major mass extinction, they have been taken as a record for the geological time scale. So there will be the volcanic eruptions are taken place, any meteoroids comes and hit on the surface. So these are the reason which have been given, answers have been given, but still there is a debatable is there about the mass extinction. Then similarly there will be appearance of the new species, new genera of the life on the surface from time to time. Then there will be continuously mountain building moments are there and mountain building continuously taking place. A drifting of continents are continuously taking place. Yes, the north plate which is coming towards the south and south plate going down, that is the Indian subcontinent which is there, which is going towards the north, and Eurasia coming down. Similarly, North America, South America, they are drifting towards the west. So these plates are drifted. Earlier one, they are united at a one particular point, Pangaea, yes, before the Precambrian, that is in the Paleozoic period, they are united, Pangaea, and surrounded by sea, Panthalsia, yes, from there, once the Permian is over, there will be a continental drifting has been taken place, there are the seven major plates are there, many smaller plates are there, and they are drifted, and now, today, what they have the position is there, that is the due to this continental drift, and this the continental drift theory now been modified and been given in the form of plate tectonic nowadays. Then there will be ocean floor spreading is there. So that phenomena also very very important. Then there will be widespread glaciation is there, South Pole, North Pole, these glaciation, if due to this what we have the global warming is there, if 1 or 1.5 degree temperature is increased. So due to that what is happening, the whatever the polar ice is there, it is going to start melting out, and 250 countries will be submerged. So that is the threat is there. So that global warming. So for this, we have to go to the past, what has happening and how they are going to make out. So these are the things which we have to study. Then dominance of certain species. For example, Cambrian is a dominance of the trilobites. So it is called as the golden era of the trilobite, that is there. Then the second one is the what we have the graptolites. It is a Ordovician. It is there. Then if you come to the next one, Permian, Carboniferous Permian, we can make out. There is a non-flowering plant is there. Cretaceous, we have the ammonites are there. Or Jurassic, we have the dinosaurs are there. So these are the thing which will be given the dominance. So those species which are dominating, we want to know exactly in which particular period these are there and why their number has gone decreasing or they are extinct. So we have to find out the reasons. So that is there. So there will be massive migration of life between the land and water are to be considered, and this is accounting to the sea what we can make out helping to the geological time scale. The changes that occur throughout the history of the earth is marked in contrast to orderly and uniform operation of natural system. Whatever the natural system which are happening on the surface of the earth, we have to make and monitor them uniformly, order properly, we have to maintain. Now early history differs characters from late history in the time scale years. Early history describes the billion years of time. The geological time scale described in million years of unit of time. The recent time is described in thousands of year unit. Experts attempt to reconstruct the scheduled events and profound changes in the aspects of geological physical system is there, and that we are going to make out in that the profound unconformity, and there we have made the divisions for making the systematic geological time scale we have been prepared. Then the understanding of geological time scale is a basic necessity for studying the geography of the earth. Then the geology of the earth. Why we geology? Because whatever the resources we are going to get, most of the resources which are there, metals which are there, we are going to get from the pre-Cambrian rocks. So we have to see in our country which are the places are there where we have the pre-Cambrian rocks. So whether we can go for the prospecting of that metals which are there, iron is there, copper is there, manganese is there, gold, silver, all varieties, uranium, thorium, whether we can get this one in that particular area, because most of the minerals deposits are there, the pre-Cambrian one. Similarly, in the Phanerozoic or in the tertiary period, we have the oil and natural gas, which is a demand, might be in the near future, maybe of 10 or 20 years, we'll find out that we are going to now using the completely, we are going to stop the use of oil and natural gas in our daily life. But rest in some industries and it will be there. But slowly that we have been transforming, because we know that next 20, 30 years, whatever the oil is there, it is going to, completely exhaust from the surface of the earth. So we should go for the alternative energies. So now battery, chargeable batteries, now on that we are going to have the four wheelers, two wheeler we are going to make out. Slowly that might be the industry, maybe switch on that particular, or wind energies, or we have the solar energies, whichever we are there. So we have to make the alternatives things to have the adaptation for the changes which are going to take place. So here in this particular video, what we have got, the geological time scale, in that what we are going to see, the first history of the time scale, then the geological time scale, what will be the scale is there, what are the criteria is there, then what is the Archean eras. Yes, that is a very important one. Then pre-Cambrian eras. Now in that pre-Cambrian or Archean which is there, that is same one, or Proterozoic, that is the what we have before the Cambrian, that is the pre-Cambrian. Earlier one it is called as Azoic and Proterozoic. And Azoic is complete blindness of the fossil, there is no chance to have a life. Then Proterozoic, there will be a traces of life, that will be unicellular animals or plants will be there, but they could not get the preserve, that will be there. Then we are going to see the Phanerozoic, in that primary, secondary, tertiary, that is Paleozoic, Mesozoic and Cenozoic. So these in detail we are going to study. So now we'll see the history, that is the most of the boundaries on the geological time scale corresponding to the origination or extinction particular kind of fossil. So we have maximum, we have taken the extinction. There is a mass extinction has been taken place, or there will be a time gap is there, and that is the hiatus we called as in the order of superposition. So there is there, and these are we are taken as a consider, and with their help, the construction of that geological time scale has taken. Knowing when the major group of fossil first appear and went extinct is taken properly, and determining the ages of the rock so that we can make the dating, and probably we can make an order of position properly. For example, if you get a rock with a trilobite fossil, upon it you get immediately know that the rock is a Paleozoic. Once you know that it is a trilobite, we say it is a Paleozoic. Then the what is the range of the Paleozoic? It is 541 million years to 252 million years. So that is the range. Similarly, not older, not younger, knowing the species of trilobite allow even greater position. So within the trilobite, we can find out what will be the calamine, paradoxite, polymers, when they are there. So we have been made that particular subdivisions also. The principal faunal succession, this is what we have the important order of what we have the stratigraphical principle has been given by the English surveyor named as William Smith. And he has given them name as a strata, and he is a father of the stratigraphy, and he studied the layer of rock to determine where to build the canals, and he found that the same ordering of fossil specimen from place to place. For example, what he has taken, fossil A was always found below the fossil B, which is turned always up above this one, found C. So A below, B in the middle and C on the above. So He has found so many such things are, he has found at many places, and on the basis of that, the order of superposition, that particular concept and the uniformatism has been come into the existence. And by documenting these sequences of the fossil, Smith was able to temporarily correlate the rock layers from place to place and establish the rock layer in two different places with equivalent age based on the fact that they include the same type of fossil. So he has done, the Smith has done excellent job, and these are, that's why we called him as a father of stratigraphy. Temporal correlation allowed Smith to construct the first geological map of entire country. He has the first person who has given the geological map of the country has been prepared. Temporal correlation has been made many people very, very rich by allowing them to predict the location of valuable geological resources such as the fossil field. Nowadays, it is very, we know that 90% of the oil is coming from the tertiary. So we want to find out in India where are the tertiary rocks are exposed. So in that tertiary, whether we can get the foraminifera, ostracod, which are the raw material for oil and natural gas. For example, if you want a tiny drop of oil from foraminifera ostracod, a minimum 1 million years are required once the animal is settled down in the marine condition and sedimentation is started. After that sedimentation, minimum 1 million years, that small drop, sand, foraminifera, tiny drop will generate the oil in 1 million years. So that's why the oil is very, very precious one, and that's why we have to see that once in the future these energies are vanished, then where we have to find out the resources. So India is still finding out resources in all these, what we have, the coastal areas are there, right from Gujarat to, we have Kanyakumari, Kanyakumari to what we have, the Calcutta. So that particular area completely we are able to sand out, so a lot of money is required. It has been tendered, has been opened for the various foreign companies. Companies are coming, tied with the Indian companies, and they are drilling out, prospecting out, and try it. We are going to get the oil and natural gas in this vicinity. More generally, it has allowed us to reconstruct the geological history of the earth by comparing the rock and fossil from place to place. If you take the Antarctica and take India, whatever the rocks we have there, if you want to compare them, then try to compare it out. Then we come to know that what will be the resources will be there in the Antarctica. Once you get that familiarity, then what will be the rocks that will be there on the lower side, we can make the comparison. It is critically important because no single place on the earth preserve a complete geological state. For example, in Pune, where the whatever the rock is exposed is the Deccan trap. Means about this, we don't have the tertiary rocks. Yes, just we have the Deccan Cretaceous. So below that, what we have? We have the Jurassic is there, Triassic is there, then we have the Paleozoic rock. So if you go to the, what we have, the Hyderabad, there the granites are exposed. If you go to the Bangalore, granites are exposed. If you go to the what we have, the Shahabad, there is a limestone is exposed, that is the Calabrese which are exposed. So these are the areas are there where a uniform rocks are not deposited. Very everywhere we have the different ages of rocks which are exposed on the surface of the earth, and we want to make them the systematically study and make the time scale, and we have to find out what are the resources will be available below that rock. The geological landscape provide global summary, countless small scale temporal correlation of rock layer made at local as well as regional level. So that much they have gone in detail, and whatever the table we have been made, the standard table which has been done, it will be remain as a standard, but rest one, there will be slight changes when the ages may take place. So that is the standardization has been done by the IGC, that is the International Geological Society, has been done that particular part, and it is based almost entirely upon careful observation of the distribution of fossil in time and space. Geological time scale is a record of earth history based on organisms which are living in the past in a different time and different places. The geology time scale is a system of chronological measurements from the surface. If we go, it is the younger, and as we go deeper and deeper, the oldest will be there. So chronological order you have to go. So you have to study the stratigraphy wise, vertical succession, horizontal succession, comparison with the fossil, ages, deposition, environmental condition, paleoclimatic conditions. So geologies, pendrologies, all will be worked together, and they will be studying this part and try to make the relationship between these events which are occurred in the Earth's history. The first geological time scale was proposed in 1913 by British geologist Arthur Holmes. This was the soon after the discovery of radioactivity, and using it, Holmes estimated that the Earth is about 4 billion years old. That is, the evidence from radioactive dating indicates that Earth is about 4.5 million years old, and this is much greater than the previously believed. And slowly, whatever we are going to have nowadays, 4.6, and still the scientists believe that it should be more than 5 billion. So the geological time scale is broken down to a manageable bits. The major divisions which have been done, it is the eons, and these two eons are based on the life, that is a fossil, and second one without fossil. So devoid of fossil or sign of fossil. So this, we have made the two major divisions. That is the what we have. Eon is the broadest category of the geological time scale. Earth history is characterized by 4 eons, in order to the oldest to the youngest, and these are earlier one, it is called as Azoic and Proterozoic, and it slowly it has been done as Hadean, Archean and Proterozoic, and now latest one, it is a Precambrian 1, Precambrian 2, Precambrian 3, Precambrian 4 and Precambrian 5, and then we have the Phanerozoic. So Cryptozoic and Phanerozoic, these are the broad eons are there, and Cryptozoic will be divided into the two, Azoic and Proterozoic. Azoic is complete blandness, and Proterozoic there is a chances, trace of life is there, and that is again, these are nowadays will be modified into Hadean, Archean and Proterozoic, and again they are modified into Precambrian 1, Precambrian 2, Precambrian 3, Precambrian 4 and Precambrian 5. This is way the what we have, the Precambrian has been divided. Now why it is called as Precambrian? Because before the Cambrian, this is the Cambrian is the lowermost division of the Paleozoic, and below that these rocks have been found, so they are called as Precambrian. So collectively Hadean, Archean and Proterozoic sometime informally referred as now Precambrian. The Cambrian period defines the beginning of the Phanerozoic eon, and all these rocks are older than the Cambrian, so they called as the Precambrian, and we live during the Phanerozoic, yes, which means the visible life is there. And this is the interval of geological time characterized by abundant, yes, here we have the abundant time is there, and there is a complex fossilized life. Being the youngest eon of the time, it is the very well represented by rocks at the Earth's surface, and because of principle of order of superposition, we have to maintain this. Because of these two factors, pendrologists and geologists study the fossils and rocks from the Phanerozoic time, and they have been slowly, Phanerozoic has been divided into the, we have the eras, Paleozoic, Mesozoic and Cenozoic, that we have been divided. Do not let the time scale at the top of this page give you a false impression. We are about a temporal duration of the Phanerozoic eon related to the three older Precambrian eons. Now we will see what we have, the Precambrian eons, Hadean, Archean, Proterozoic and a Phanerozoic. These are what we have, the eons, Hadean, Archean, Proterozoic and Phanerozoic. And these Hadean, Archean and what we have, the Proterozoic, earlier it is called as Cryptozoic, nowadays it is called as Precambrian. Precambrian 1, Precambrian 2, Precambrian 3, Precambrian 4, Precambrian 5. Hadean is 30%, Archean 33%, Proterozoic years 42%, and nowadays we have a here in Phanerozoic there is a 12%. So whatever the time scale has been there, that is a 4.6 billion years are there, they have it divided into that this particular percentage. Now we are there on the today, and now 4 billion years, that will be the given the what we have the life of starting of the earth. So you have already learned that the earth is 4.54 billion old, but now the now advanced we have 5 billion, more than that 4.6 has been now everyone is agree, so that will be there. Phanerozoic eon begin 5 to 41 million years ago, that is 0.5 to 41 billion years ago. The Phanerozoic eon represent a paltry 12% of the earth history. Instead of the most of the history earth history is represented by the Precambrian one. These older eons tell the story of the and majority of whatever we get the economic mineral deposits, they are the from the Precambrian. The Hadean and Archean are the difficult eons to study. However, because they are the exposed in a very limited places in Earth's surface, since they are all the oldest eons, rocks that are Hadean and Archean in age are often buried far below the younger beds within the surface. So that is also a problematic. We could not get this the exposure of this particular one. So Proterozoic, which span nearly 2 billion years, yes, 42% of the Earth's history, and are much more accessible, but until recently have received significantly less attention from the paleontologists than rocks from the younger fossil rich in Phanerozoic eons. That is slowly beginning to change. However, as more clues about the origin of complex of life begin to be revealed from the Proterozoic age fossils, that is we have the more primitive life, that is unicellular organism is there. The fossil bearing rocks which are classified Phanerozoic, that is a visible life, 542 billion years to the present, and those lack of fossils were classified Proterozoic before life up to 544 billion years. So before that we have the Proterozoic. Some Phanerozoic, Proterozoic rocks did in fact contain primitive life, that is a more unicellular soft tissued organism is there, but they could not fossilize because they don't have the skeleton. The Proterozoic now defined as the specific interval of time is 2.5 billion years to 542 million years. It's a huge one. The two additional eras has been added to the geological timescale, that is Archean, that is 4 to 2.5 billion years, and Hadean from 4.6 to 4 billion is Hadean, then Archean, then the what we are going to make out the Proterozoic. The use of fossil for dating of rock was of course limited to those rocks which contain the fossil. That is only we are going to get into the Phanerozoic one, but in the what we have the Proterozoic, we don't have the fossils which are there, avoid of fossil is there. So there we are going to use the rocks. Now this eons are divided into the eras. Eons are divided into the eras. Eons of the geological time scale is subdivided into eras, and wherever it is subdivided, there is we have a profound unconformity, and that is the second longest unit. This is the second one. First one is eon. Now we know eon is divided into the eras. That is the second longest unit as compared. We are going to make out. So the Phanerozoic eon is divided into three: early, middle, and the late, or early, middle, and late, or we have primary, secondary, or tertiary. Paleozoic, paleo means late, Mesozoic means intermediate, and Ceno means early, the recent one. So Paleozoic, Mesozoic, and Cenozoic, these are what we have the eras of Phanerozoic. Yes, you can see now Phanerozoic, where we have the life is there, fossils are available. Now they are divided into the eons: Paleozoic, old life; Mesozoic, middle life;
and Cenozoic new life. You can see now 541 Paleozoic started and it is ended in 252 million years. Then Mesozoic from 252 to 66 million years, and from 66 to the today, what we have, the recent, that is the Cenozoic. So Paleozoic, Mesozoic and Cenozoic, these are the broad divisions of what we have, the Phanerozoic. Most of our knowledge of the fossil record comes from the three eras, Paleozoic, Mesozoic and Cenozoic. Paleozoic is the old life era, yes, the old one, and where the trilobite is the first limbed vertebrate is there and the origin of land plants. Mesozoic, it is the middle life era, represent the age of dinosaurs and also noteworthy for the first appearance of mammals and flowering one. So Mesozoic will be having the flowering plants and mammals will be just started is there, but that will be given main is the age of dinosaurs. The trilobite, what we have, the Jurassic is the dinosaurs age is there. Finally, the Cenozoic, that is the new life, the era somewhat is called as age of mammals. We are there on this Cenozoic duration, so we live today. So what we have, the temporal points of reference is worth memorizing is the age of the boundaries. The separate the three eras of the Phanerozoic era. Long before geologists know these absolute ages and the boundaries which are giving you the history of life as well as the mass extinction. For example, many fossils that are being commonly found in youngest Paleozoic are not found in ore-like Mesozoic. So they might be extinct over there itself. And some of them are there, they have been started in Paleozoic, but they are still, they are there in the recent. But that is what is happening. Their number of species and the genus has been, there will be a variation has been taken place. They have been completely survived. Similarly, the dinosaur fossil also found in the youngest Mesozoic rock, but they were again found on the overlying Cenozoic. So Triassic, that is the Jurassic and Cretaceous. Yes. So Jurassic dinosaurs are dominating, but end of the Jurassic, everything is dinosaurs over, so we don't have in the Cretaceous one. So paleontologists and geologists, they use these mass extinction event to define these boundaries within the Phanerozoic portions of the geological time scale. Therefore, no coincidence that some of the major boundaries coincided with the mass extinction events. The older Archean and Proterozoic eons are similarly divided. Yes, now we had just discussed about the Phanerozoic. Now come to the next one. We have the Cryptozoic. Now in that, Archean and Proterozoic eons are similarly divided into several eras. For example, the younger era of the Proterozoic eon is called as Neoproterozoic. For sake of simplicity, these older eras are not been included on the time scale shown at the top of this page. They do, however, exist. Yes. These three eras are recognized. Already we have done Paleozoic, Mesozoic, Cenozoic. When we are going to start, always start from the bottom. Paleozoic, Mesozoic, Cenozoic, 251 to 542 million, then 655 to 251 million, and 0 to 65 million years before. Then eras further subdivided into periods, and periods can be subdivided to the epochs. Come to the next one, the eras will be divided into the periods. The Paleozoic, the early life what we have, is the what we have, Cambrian, Ordovician, Silurian, Devonian, Carboniferous and Permian. So Cambrian, Ordovician, Silurian, Devonian, Carboniferous, Permian. Right from the bottom you have to go to the top. Cambrian, Ordovician, Silurian, Devonian, Carboniferous and Permian. You can see the ages of the Paleozoic, 541 million years to till 252 million years. So that is the span of the Paleozoic. Then the Mesozoic era, it is divided into Triassic, Jurassic and Cretaceous. You can see 252 million years to 66 million. Within this span, we have the Mesozoic era. Then finally come to the Cenozoic, which has been divided into Paleogene, Neogene and Quaternary. The Cenozoic will be divided into Paleogene, Neogene. These two are the tertiary one and the Quaternary. Nowadays Quaternary is also been called as the recent, from 66 million years to the present. So these are the what we have, the division which are made. Just as you want to subdivide into eras, eras are subdivided into the times, units of time are called periods. So most of the periods, Jurassic period of the Mesozoic, that is the very famous for the dinosaurs. So Jurassic Park, everyone know that movie, that where the dinosaurs will be there, and everyone, the small child, you also know Jurassic Park. Then the next one, Paleozoic era, is divided into six periods. Yeah, that is starting from the Cambrian, that is the oldest one. Cambrian, Ordovician, Silurian, Devonian, Carboniferous and Permian. This is where the sequence is there. Note that in United States and Carboniferous is divided into two separate periods, that is Mississippian and Pennsylvanian. So remember these words will be used in this. So these are the US one. Periods of geological tenses are subdivided into epochs. Then epochs are divided into the narrower unit of time, which is called as the ages. For the sake of simplicity, only epochs of Paleogene, Neogene, Quaternary are shown in the time scale at the top of this. They are the important one as compared to the fossil, what we have, oil and natural gas. This is important to know. However, all these periods of Enerozoic eras are subdivided into epochs and as well as the ages. The Paleogene period is divided into form oldest to youngest, Paleocene. Yes, Paleocene, Eocene, Oligocene, Miocene and Pliocene. So the Paleogene is divided into Paleocene, Eocene, Oligocene, whereas Neogene is divided into Miocene and Pliocene. And finally the Quaternary is divided into Pleistocene and Holocene. Now Holocene will be the recent one. Some geologists now think that since the human are having a notable impact on the earth and its life, a new youngest epochs are added to the Quaternary, that is the Anthropocene. Yes, remember these are the thing which will be updated now. There is still considerable discussion on the geological community about epochs should be added, as well as debate about what characteristic should be define its beginning. So now I can see Paleogene and Neogene, these are the tertiaries. Then we have a Quaternary. Now Paleogene is divided to Paleogene, Eocene, Oligocene. Neogene will be divided into Miocene, Pliocene, and Quaternary, Pleistocene and Holocene. And this Paleocene will start in 66. Then the, what we have, the Pleistocene is there 11.8, and Holocene, which we are there in the today, what we have, the present one. The best way to illustrating is show you how these subdivisions work for the Enerozoic. The important things today lecture is during this division of geological periods. The name used Cambrian for a specific locality. Yes, now whatever the names are given, like Cambrian, Ordovician, Silurian, Devonian, Carboniferous, Permian, Triassic, Jurassic, Cretaceous, Neogene, Paleogene, then the Quaternary and the Holocene. So these are the names which are given for the each particular places, or on the basis of the location where this first time the rocks are studied and the ages which are given on that particular one. So these are the important things, and these rocks which are there, they have been dated if we don't have the fossil and we have been constructed the geological time scale. The dates are regularly modified if the better radiative analysis are developed. But the division themselves are fixed. But now the whatever the divisions we have made, they are the fixed one. They represent the major changes in the fossil record. For example, the boundary between the Mesozoic and Cenozoic, that is 65 million years, there is a major extinction event. Dinosaurs are extinct and there is the volcanic eruption which has been taken place. Then the boundary between Paleocene and Mesozoic, Paleozoic and Mesozoic, that is 250 million years represent and the bigger event of extinction. So these are everywhere the extinction which are there, they are the major records, and on the basis of that we have been done the divisions. Radioactive material dating puts the absolute date on the geological division, but the divisions are largely based on the paleontological nature. Now the whole geological time scale, now see, now Eden, Archean, Proterozoic, these are the older one, pre-Cambrian one. Then we have Paleozoic, that is the Phanerozoic, these are the Phanerozoic, these are the Cryptozoic. Now Proterozoic, Azoic and the Proterozoic, and Azoic will be divided into Eden and Archean and Proterozoic. Nowadays we have pre-Cambrian 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Then we have the Phanerozoic is divided into Paleozoic, Mesozoic, Cenozoic, early, middle and a late. Then we have Cambrian, Ordovician, Silurian, Devonian, Carboniferous, Permian, Triassic, Jurassic, Cretaceous, Paleogene, Neogene, Quaternary. And now here Paleocene, Eocene, Oligocene, Miocene, Pliocene, Pleistocene and Holocene. So this is the way the whole geological time scale, and this is what we have the given the geological time on the watch, it has been given. So we have to be go on detail make out. This is the what we have the principle of order of superposition. How the rocks are studied horizontally, they have been made studied, and lithology has been pronounced. Yes, so here we have the Eden, then Archean, then Proterozoic, early, middle, late, early, middle, late, then Proterozoic, Mesozoic and Cenozoic. So combined, we are given in detail the eras, then their duration, and the what we have the ages, what we are going to make out. So this is the again enlarged here, Precambrian, Cambrian, Ordovician, Silurian, Devonian. Then we have here the Carboniferous, that is the Mississippian and Pleistocene, then Permian, Triassic, Jurassic, Cretaceous, and then the Tertiary, Quaternary. And in the Tertiary, we have Pliocene, Eocene, Oligocene, Pliocene and Eocene, then Pleistocene, Holocene. So this is the way the geological time scale. And now how these are the geological time scale has been done, evolution time scale. See, this is the way the thing has been done in everyone, and there will be a body which is there, and that body will be monetized, will be monitoring this, whatever the changes which are going to face. But whatever the divisions which have been made, these divisions are made perfectly based on. So here we have seen the geological time scale. I hope this will be clear, the concept will be clear. So right from the bottom you have to start to the tail, and whatever the concept which is there behind, the scientists who have worked, geologists who has worked behind this one, credit has to go to them, and they have done an excellent job. And on the basis of that, today whatever we know the stratigraphy, we try to search for in our areas oil and natural gas, or whichever the mineral we are requiring from Precambrian, metallic minerals, oil and this what we are, the diamonds, gold, silver, copper. So where these localities are there, we can try to find out with the help of the stratigraphy. Thank you. Have a nice day.